हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेक्निया टीवी। आई मानसी चोपड़ा, फैकल्टी ऑफ बीएजीएमसी डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम टेक्निया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एडवांस स्टडीज इज गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन अल्टरनेटिव पैराडाइम, दैट इज पार्टिसिपेटरी डेवलपमेंट। द अप्रोच अडॉप्टेड इन द 1990s बाय द यूनाइटेड नेशंस एंड अदर डेवलपमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एज की चैलेंजेस टू बी एड्रेस सक्सेसफुली। कॉमन फीचर्स ऑफ दिस पर्सपेक्टिव आर द एम्फेसिस ऑन पीपल, द एंडोजीनियस विजन ऑफ डेवलपमेंट एंड द attention to power and rights issue. Participatory approaches require a shift in the way of individuals are considered from passive recipients to active agents of development efforts. In addition to poverty reduction, they include objectives in education, gender equality and health issues. Most development priorities are outlined with political frameworks based on the adherence to good governance and democratic principles, for example freedom and human rights. The major reasons for the adoption of this approach in development initiatives maintaining that 1. Services can be provided at a lower cost. 2. Participation as intrinsic values for participants, elevating feelings of alienation and powerlessness. 3. Participation is a catalyst for further development efforts. 4. Participation leads to a sense of responsibility for the project. 5. Participation ensures the use of indigenous knowledge and expertise. The participation is not an absolute concept and that it can be applied in different degree is part of the problem. The approach of facilitates people involvement in the problem analysis process and it stimulates the reversal of learning from the rural poor to the experts. They both share a sincere concern for the empowerment of the poorest and the most disadvantaged sector of society, which often tend to be in rural areas or on the periphery of urban agglomerates. It claims that participatory research should not be neutral but should always side with the poor and the marginalized. Features of participatory approach are the emphasis on participation is development also implies increased attention to communication because there can be no participation without communication, at least without a certain type of communication. Finally, the participation mode also addresses poverty or at least one of its key dimensions in a direct way. Poverty is not simply the deprivation of basic material needs, it concerns other significant dimensions of people's life. Social exclusion is one of the elements contributing to the overall poverty dimensions. Eliminating or significantly reducing social exclusions, though the dialogic use of communication is a step towards a world without poverty. By engaging stakeholders who often have been excluded from any form of decision making in their lives and allowing them to engage in the decision making process, development communication not only reduces people's capability disadvantage. In other words, the added emphasis on participation helps to mainstream communication in any initiatives and at the same time promotes a more dialogic and two-way conception of communication. I hope you understand the topic of participatory development. For more videos, please like and subscribe Technia TV. Thank you.